this project I'm calling Captain King. The recipient, whose last name is King, obviously is inspired by that. Also, if I get a good picture of the delivery, you can see his glorious beard because it's glorious. And it's because of that that I was inspired to do a kind of an old world pirate theme, but like a space pirate theme. And it one thing led to another, and once I started the whole space pirate idea, it sort of snowballed after that, which gave way to lightsaber cutlass, which gave way to space pirate treasure chest, which is what this is, and a whole bunch of other stuff. But really, it's mostly inspired by the recipient and the fact that he's just one of those kinds of guys and stuff like that. He's a dude I work with. Good dude. Awesome beard. So the space box ended up basically just being like a themed box, but with greebles on it, like space type greebles. Also, there's some lights on it and stuff. You can see down on the far end, there's three of them. The green ones are 8mm, just regular LEDs that take 20 milliamps. The ones down here are just, they're auto flashing. So that's pretty much it, really, just to enhance the whole space pirate theme, whatnot. But I had that big, huge red push button that I had no idea what I was ever gonna use it for. But hey, it worked really well for this project, so. But the catch is this thing right here. I made a circle so that you can open it like that. And this is the lightsaber cutlass. It's a little shorter. Total, it's 36 and a half, including the hilt. Just because, like, the whole idea of cutlass is that they're short, close quarters. But yeah, I think I was able to capture something in there. If you'll notice, there's a little, that the emitter is kind of a crown, which adds to the king theme. I wanted to do a cutlass for a long time, but I wasn't entirely sure how to do the guard. And so with the bend right there, and there's a little bit of beveling here, so that also sort of helps sell the cupping, but it's, again, it's still just flat. And totally giving away all the secrets here. Anyway, but it's got a prism.
Steel Sword 2.
And it's running Steel Sword 2. Phoenix Pyre, just because the orange looks really cool. Nova Star, one of my favorites. Nightfall, one of my favorites. Night Wraith. Anyway, but I think it's on blue, so. And the switch plate is so that, like, it should fall right in the spacing of your hand, and for me, this is pretty much the ideal position, just like this. I actually measured his hand so that I could see where the switches are, so his hand's a little bit bigger, and again, I haven't delivered it yet, obviously, but hopefully his hand is just big enough so that he can reach these two buttons to, without having to turn the hilt. Anyway, but but with the heavy flicker, I thought it looked really good. This is a little bit kind of red-orangey mix. It's not straight red, it's not orange, it's red-orange. I've always liked this font just because of the... If you've ever been a kid at a bonfire and you set a stick on fire, that's pretty familiar, so. Oof, hurts my ears. Just that bird. It's awesome.
Silver Star.
One of my favorites. So the colors, they're struck mostly to primary colors, just different hues. With, I mean, I did purple too, a couple purples. This is white, it just looks still purpley in the camera. That's red, comparable to red-orange and orange. I don't think you can actually see the difference now that I'm looking for it. Kind of a gold-yellow, back to green, so. Yeah, that's the lightsaber cutlass. The cram foo wasn't really that big of an issue since it's a 1.25 inch outer diameter tube, so there's plenty of space on the inside. It's just planning it out that took a little bit of time. More MHS, obviously. Can't really do anything without a little bit of MHS just because it's so versatile. But I really like how it turned out. The idea for the entire project was, well, I'm not gonna get into the whole space pirate theme, but ideal. I wanted to sort of treat it like an archaeological thing. I don't really plan on explaining any of the markings or the symbology on the box, because that's honestly for the owner to take part in. So if he wants to, he can make up stories and stuff that explains what this is and what that is and stuff, but otherwise it really wasn't something that I was worried about. I just started making things and that's how it goes. But a couple of things that are included: this is a shoulder belt lanyard strap thing that hooks onto the frog. Holding it and stuff like that, and the two little rings right there to hold on, because I was looking up frog, and most of, like, belt frogs and stuff that come up for swords, but when I started looking at cutlass frog, it was over the shoulder thing, and that seemed to be fairly universal. I have no idea what that's about, but down on the end, I don't know if you can see, but there's the charger right here, and a slot for the SD card and stuff, and Velcro strips, because there's Velcro loop right there, so I just made some hook straps to go over that so that you can secure it down. And I'm looking through the camera, you can sort of see there's an 18500 in there, but I painted over all the wires, so hopefully you can't see it, but it still kind of looks cool. But yeah, that is a lightsaber cutlass. Thanks for watching. See you later.